In June 2021, a man was lured on a dating app to meet in the town of Flora, Indiana, to meet on false pretenses, and when he arrived, he was robbed and murdered. The man was 55-year-old Willie Lee Smith Jr. of Lafayette, Indiana. He was going to meet a woman in Flora named Cheyenne Brooks Brown, a 24-year-old woman who he was communicating with on the dating app MeetMe. The plan was for Willie to have a paid sexual encounter with Cheyenne. On June 16, 2021, Willie Lee Smith Jr. drove his dark blue 2004 Volvo to Flora to meet the woman and arrived around 2:39 a.m. parking on East Clem Street. When Willie got there, he saw Cheyenne and talked to her. As he was talking to Cheyenne, a man ran out from a hiding spot and hit him twice on the head with a baseball bat. He was robbed and his wallet was taken. At approximately 5:15 a.m., a Flora police sergeant was called to investigate a report of an intruder at a home on East Clem Street. The occupants inside the house informed the police they awoke to find an unresponsive, severely injured black male with a traumatic physical injury to his face on the couch in their living room. The male was 55-year-old Willie Lee Smith Jr., and his car was discovered parked nearby on the same street. A set of keys were found on the ground around droplets of blood near Smith's car. A receipt with the timestamp 1:05 a.m. was found at the scene, indicating a withdrawal of $120 from an ATM at a First Merchants Bank in Lafayette. At approximately 1 p.m., Carroll County Prosecutor's Office investigator Steve Mullen was notified by Flora Police Chief Paul Redman that he had discovered security video showing an individual walking in front of the cameras near 320 S Center Street earlier that morning. The individual was a black male wearing a bright orange shirt who was seen walking on East Main Street at approximately 9 a.m. The Flora police had identified three people at a woman named Jennifer Barnes residence that may be involved with the incident. They were Cheyenne Brooks, Matthew Troyer, and Tyrone Leftridge. The three were seen rapidly loading items into a vehicle. A Flora police officer knew the driver of the vehicle, who was Tyrone Leftridge. Leftridge spoke to police and wanted to get the situation straightened out. After being told he wasn't in custody and could leave the Flora Police Department at any time, Tyrone Leftridge at first denied any knowledge of the incident, but then admitted to knowing what happened. He stated that the plan was to lure Willie Smith to the location, and Leftridge said that he was hiding in a nearby garage when Willie Smith arrived. Leftridge said he heard Jennifer Barnes' husband, Corey Dean, attack Smith from behind and put him on the ground. Leftridge then said to the police that he wanted to leave the police department and did so. Moments after Leftridge left, Flora Police Chief Paul Redman advised another law enforcement official that Cheyenne Brooks Brown stated that Leftridge had told her not to talk to the police because he had done something bad that morning. At this point, Leftridge was detained. The next morning, Officer Thomas and Investigator Mullen listened to a jail phone call between Leftridge and another person. During this call, Leftridge had admitted he had hit Willie Smith Jr. with a baseball bat because he had a knife. Later that day at approximately 2 p.m., Chief Paul Redman and Investigator Mullen spoke with Cheyenne Brooks Brown. She admitted on the morning of the 16th, Leftridge used her social media app on her iPhone named MeetMe, broadcasting her information to those logged on. She said it was Leftridge who told her the arrangement was for her to have sex with this man for $80. She told him she was not a prostitute and was not going to have sex. She claimed she did not see a knife in Willie Smith's hand, nor did he touch her or was rude to her. She admitted to seeing Leftridge come out of hiding and saw him hit Willie twice with a baseball bat. Cheyenne said she turned after she saw the attack happen and ran to Jennifer Barnes Dean and Corey Dean's residence at 320 S Division, and later saw Leftridge enter with cash in denominations of $20 bills, a wallet, and another cell phone. 55-year-old Willie Lee Smith Jr. passed away 2 days later on June 18, 2021 from blunt trauma to the head sustained during the commission of the robbery. 22-year-old Tyrone Leftridge was originally arrested on Wednesday, June 16th for robbery and battery of Smith, who was transported to IU Hospital in Lafayette after he was discovered unconscious around 5:15 a.m. that morning on East Clem Street in Flora. On Monday, June 21, 2021, the prosecutor's office amended charges against Tyrone Leftridge of Lafayette to murder and robbery following the findings of Smith's autopsy at the Marion County Coroner's Office.
Our top story at 6, 55-year-old Willie Smith of Lafayette was robbed and beaten to death in Flora. 22-year-old Tyrone Leftridge, also of Lafayette, was charged today with murder.
And police say he used a dating app on a woman's cell phone to lure Smith to that small town. News 18's Joe Paul attended his initial court hearing today. Joe reports from Flora with the latest on the investigation.
Smith was found inside this home in the 100 block of East Clem Street in Flora. The residents had called police to report a possible intruder. That's where officers found Smith unresponsive with traumatic injuries to his face. He was flown to IU Health Methodist Hospital in Indianapolis, where he died. You can see the location of the home on your screen right now. Leftridge was charged Friday with felony counts of robbery resulting in serious bodily injury and aggravated battery. He was also charged Monday with one count of murder. A woman told detectives Leftridge used a dating app on her phone to impersonate her and facilitate a sexual encounter with Smith for $80. The woman told police Leftridge was hiding behind a nearby garage when Smith arrived and hit him twice in the head with a baseball bat. I spoke with Lucy Cruey, who has lived in Flora for 32 years. She says the small town has seen several tragedies over the past several years.
It just was really odd to be in this area. We have quiet neighbors. You know, I have a nurse's neighbor. We have elderlies. We have somebody that's always involved in our community. Can't wait to kind of find out the true story, and I do hope they get answers.
In a recorded jail phone call, police say Leftridge admitted to hitting Smith, quote, because he had a knife, end quote, but the woman says Smith wasn't armed during the encounter. A receipt found at the scene suggests Smith made a $120 withdrawal from a Lafayette ATM earlier that morning on Wednesday. The woman told police she saw Leftridge back at a Flora home with cash, a wallet, and another cell phone. Reporting in Flora, Joe Paul, News 18.
Shianne Brooks Brown, 24, of Delphi, was arrested in the evening of Monday, June 21st, and held on charges of murder and robbery for her alleged involvement in the incident.
Our top story at 6, a second person has been charged in connection to a robbery and deadly beating of a Lafayette man in Flora. News 18's Joe Paul spoke with the victim's daughter about the aftermath of that brutal attack. He joins us in the studio tonight with the latest on the investigation. Joe?
Hey, Sam. Police say the pair lured 55-year-old Willie Smith to Flora using a dating app to facilitate a fake sexual encounter, then beat him to death with a baseball bat. We have to warn you, some viewers might find the following images disturbing.
Someone did this. Someone beat him in the head with the bat, and you need to get here.
Jeanette Smith was in Mexico celebrating her sister's college graduation when she answered a call from a hospital about her father.
Immediately, I thought that his kidneys failed again because he does have stage 5 renal kidney failure, which is a terminal illness.
But an autopsy shows Willie Smith died from blunt force trauma to his head. His daughter shared pictures of the traumatic injuries to a now viral Facebook post.
It hurt me to do that, but I want people to see what these people did to him.
22-year-old Tyrone Leftridge and 24-year-old Shianne Brooks Brown face charges of robbery and murder. Police say they used a dating app to lure Smith to Flora for an $80 sexual encounter, then beat him to death and stole his money.
When someone has a family, they should not have to die alone. And he died alone. And that really, you know, messed me up.
Smith was awaiting a kidney transplant when he was killed. His daughter says he was able to provide a gift he never received himself.
He was on the donor list. And because of that, I went ahead and donated a few of his organs. So he's still a hero. He actually saved 2 lives on Father's Day. He gave 1 lung and his liver to 2 recipients.
The family's next move is to formally identify Smith's body, which his daughter fears will leave permanent scars.
Because of how horrific he's going to look because of what they've done to him.
Smith was found inside a home in the 100 block of East Clem Street in Flora, but police are not releasing the location of the attack, and investigators aren't ruling out further arrests in this case. Reporting in the studio, Joe Paul, News 18.
Almost a month later, on July 14, 2021, 42-year-old Jennifer Lynn Barnes-Dean was charged with robbery and murder. Willie Lee Smith Jr.'s missing wallet was found in her home on top of a camera. The baseball bat that was used to kill Willie was also found washed in Jennifer's home. The question still remains as to why it took almost a month to arrest Jennifer after the crime occurred. Tyrone and Sheehan were in a relationship and staying with Jennifer and her husband, Corey Dean, on 320 S Division Street in Flora at the time of the murder. Jennifer became a mother figure to Sheehan. Sheehan's father was previously in a relationship with Jennifer. Tyrone said the two women he was with, Sheehan and Jennifer, were the ones who did the beating on Willie Smith. On August 4th, 2022, Jennifer Lynn Barnes was sentenced to 60 years at the Indiana Department of Corrections for murder. On September the 2nd, 2022, she started the appeal process for her sentence. On October 23rd, 2022, Tyrone Leftridge accepted a plea deal and was sentenced to 45 years at the Indiana Department of Corrections for murder. Sheehan Brooks Brown still hasn't been sentenced, and her trial starts in December 2023.